marcellee.com. MARCELLEE.com.
What are you out here passing out?
Passing out info about the reality of the treatment and what the animals go through for our food.
And give examples of that. What do you mean?
Well, because of the growth of the food industry and like consolidation and industrialization and everything, the confinement and things that animals go through is much more intense and cruel than it used to be traditionally. And that's basically what we're like spreading awareness about, so people will make more conscious decisions in their food consumption and in their buying practices and all that. That's the only way really we feel like the industry will adjust and like make things better is if they're feeling the economic impact. So that's basically what this is about. We're raising awareness so people can make a difference in their own daily lives, you know.
Okay, so for people who don't know, give an example of what a chicken or a cow, for example, might go through before.
Well, the chickens actually are the most affected now, because for so many years we've been told that it's the healthier one to eat. So much of the industry has gone towards that it's almost it's 90 to 95% of all the animals affected by our food choices are our chickens now. And especially common regular like grocery store eggs that you buy, the chickens that are in those cages that are for years in there, their whole lives pretty much, it's very hard to imagine. But just in this pamphlet that I'm giving out, the chickens have basically the space of like a pamphlet like this, slightly bigger than an iPad, for instance, for years. So it's almost like, if you can imagine, like being strapped to an airplane seat for years, if you could think about it. So that's the intensity of it is very real. And it's chickens are the main ones, but pigs also, with the breeding pigs, are also confined in spaces where they can't turn around even, or move pretty much at all while they have babies. And so you just have to put yourself in their shoes, and if you want to contribute to a system that has them like that, it's to me, I realized that a couple of years ago, and I just couldn't participate anymore. And you don't really need to go vegetarian or vegan to even make a difference with this. You can like do meatless Mondays. You can skip meat like for a meal or two or a couple times a week, and it actually will make a difference.
So it's strictly a moral argument you're making.
Well, that's to me, it's a moral argument. But the issue is very, it's so widespread. It also, it's an environmental impact now. Because of the concentrated farming, these farms where the animals are like really intensely confined, like I was explaining, it's about more pollution is caused by that than it is by transportation in total now. And like that, our health is greatly impacted. The two greatest causes of death in the U.S. is heart disease and diabetes, you know, and that's directly related to our overconsumption of animal products.
Can't the argument be made, and if you've never heard this argument, it may sound far-fetched or out there, but can't the argument be made that we're really no different than a lion, you know, hunting for prey? I mean, in other words, you know, morality is subjective, you know, so at least that's what I think. You may not agree,
yeah,
but...
Yeah, no, totally. With that, the argument there, it's very common, but it's based on misconceptions. Like we're nowhere near a carnivore like a lion is. In our practices we're omnivores, but if you look at our biology, our in intestinal tracts, how long it is.
But apparently we are, if we're eating meat though.
Well, no. We're hardwired to get as much sugar and protein as we can in our diet, because it used to be that was our survival needs. But that's not our survival needs anymore. We just are hardwired over evolution to become like that. But if you look at the intestinal tracts of a tiger or a lion or a carnivore or smaller ones, it's very short. And they eat the meat and they process it fast and they get it out. We have intestinal tracts that are much more based like a herbivore, to eat plants that takes a long time for it to get through our system. And not just that, if you look at our teeth, we don't have canines we have teeth that are called canines, but if you really look at them, they aren't. We have teeth much more similar to a cow or something than to a tiger or a lion.
So you couldn't justify just eating for pleasure?
No, no.
Because it tastes good.
What I was saying, it's true. It does taste good. I went through most of my life enjoying eating animals like everybody else. But
and by the way, not to cut you off, but I totally agree with you that it's wrong what they're doing to these animals. I'm just having trouble making a connection between what they're doing being wrong and me being wrong for eating it once it's already dead, you know?
Yeah. Well, the connection is because they're only doing it because they're getting the economic benefit that we give them by participating.
But if I stop eating it, you know, I don't know if that will save even one chicken. You know what I mean?
Well, no. It does. Totally, it does. I mean, annually, if you don't eat meat, you can save over 30 land animals every year. Even more if you don't eat fish and like shrimp and animals like that. That's making the difference right now. I mean, like the industry, because of sales, where they see it as the biggest profit is moving towards cage-free products, is moving towards humane meat. Those are the biggest growth industries, and like the alternative meats that like are soy-based, things like that. Even those are such big industry growth right now because of how much people are buying it, that the meat companies themselves are looking to try to get in on it and buy these companies that are making bigger profits than they are. So it does make a difference. It totally does. And it's, you know, it's a consumer driven thing.
Okay. Any last words or messages or advice to anybody watching this?
I just would recommend it. You do what you can. I mean, if you believe in karma and like that, you know, we're responsible for our effects in this world, you need to try to do everything you can to change your behavior. Change our behavior. It's not the easiest thing. It took me a couple times to try and fail and keep trying, but everybody can make a difference. So that's what I say. Like, you do what you can. You the rewards are more than I can tell you. Yeah.